But there are more stocks in news. And remember, 8K Miles was very active last week or the week before last, if I'm not wrong. They've done a number of things. The stock is trading at 14.14. That's really good. It's very close, I believe, to its 52-week highs as well. I'll just tell you what that number is. But 8K Miles, yes, 14.44 is the 52-week high. So this is one company that is trading close to 52-week highs. And it's done a couple of things. They've acquired US-based NextAge Technologies for $3 million. It's the fourth acquisition in the last 12 months. You've seen a number of those flashes as well. Let's get in Mr. Suresh Venkatachari, Chairman and CEO of 8K Miles. They are doing a lot of things right. Let's try and figure out what would all of this mean for the company and the numbers and business over the next 12 to 24 months. Good to have you, Mr. Venkatachari. Thanks so much for joining in. You know, it's a pleasure to know that there are companies which are regarded so well and trading at close to life highs in a market scenario like this. Let's talk about NextAge, though. What does it bring to the table? It's not a very large acquisition, but can you shed some light on what does NextAge do? Does it itself become EPS accretive? And how would it aid business for 8K Miles over a period of the next 12 to 24 months?
Yeah, great. Thank you for having me, Neeraj. 8K Miles is a secure cloud company. We focus on providing enterprise-wide solutions for pharma and life science healthcare industries. And NextAge actually fit into our life scale market. NextAge has a great potential to scale up our cloud business into the pharma and life science vertical. NextAge has like a computer system validation. They were like in the 15 years old company, built a lot of services around pharma and life science industry, and which is the very strong requirement for 8K Miles to dominate in the space. Our acquisition of NextAge is mainly for domain expertise, because in the pharma validation sector, the compliance is a very, very key vertical, key aspect, and 8K Miles provide a secured cloud solutions. So it's a perfect fit for our growth.
So tell us, how big is this opportunity when it comes to life sciences? And more importantly, would you be open to further acquisitions? Are there any gaps that you need to be filled even post this?
Yeah, basically this acquisition will help us in the 12 to 24 months to ramp up our client acquisitions actually in the market, and also to grow the revenues more organically. See, very important in the space of the cloud is actually many players are entering into the market, and the leadership is a very, very critical thing. And we want to attain the leadership in the both healthcare and pharma vertical, and we are investing both in organic and inorganic acquisitions. So we look at a complementary services all the time. So that is one of the reasons in the last four acquisitions we acquired in the both healthcare and pharma sector to improve our quality of offerings. And we are acquiring many new customers in the pharma vertical. So with the NextAge, it will help us to strengthen our overall offering and also to be deep inside the pharma vertical. We are also building like a pharma analytics on top of our cloud EasyRx platform, which is a very, very significant need for the hour, because many of the drug manufacturers, they have to do a lot of analytics, and the current technology or the infrastructure doesn't support, and cloud is a way to go. And to meet that, you need to have a GBX compliant platform, and that's what our cloud EasyRx offer. And with the NextAge, it actually fits into the computer system validation and data migration and services.
So are your acquisitions, aside of course, giving you the fill in the blank kind of strategy, are they also geography based? The point that I'm trying to make is, would you be looking at now making acquisitions in certain European areas as well to make inroads into those markets too?
A good question, actually. So we were focused predominantly on the North American market. Our majority of our revenue generated from North American markets currently. And we started expanding into Europe slowly. And in fact, we hired recently a head of our operation and non-US sales focus on European market a month back. So we are focusing on Europe. And in fact, a couple of customers we won, Big Pharma, which is based in the Basel, Switzerland. So we do see a great opportunity in the Europe too. But the first priority is actually to get as much as possible in the North America, and then slowly get into Europe and Middle East.
Okay. Now give me a sense of your revenue profile. For a lot of people, what 8K Miles is doing is now known. What about numbers? How have the numbers worked up on the last couple of years, and how do you expect them to shape up over the next couple?
Okay, we don't give any forecast, but however, I can just take you back. Like we did about 44 crores 2 years back, and last year we grown to 120 plus crores, and the last quarter we did about 50 crores. So pretty much we actually last year we close to tripled our revenue, and quarter on quarter we are growing for last 4 to 6 quarters consistently on 20%. So we continue to expect to grow in this fashion. And if you see why the growth is actually accelerating in the last 2 years is mainly because the cloud market is expanding, and still the market is not fully reached the potential. Only I would say between 5 to 10% of the enterprises are adapting the cloud, and there is a great opportunity to address the remaining 90% of the market share. So that is one of the main reason 8KMiles is focusing on very, very selective areas where we can able to make a clear differentiator from other providers. Not at being a generalist, we want to be a very focused, secured compliance architecture we build. And also our building architecture is basically, we don't build basically on a people-based model. We build on a SaaS model and a managed services model. Our revenues are actually not directly proportionate to the number of employees what we add on a quarter or yearly basis. So we, as many enterprises started using our solutions as a SaaS offering, our revenues will significantly increase. And we would expect in the next 24 to 36 months, we can see a gain an addressable market share.
What about your margins? Do you think they can be improved from the current 31.4% odd levels?
It is actually a pressure for me, right? Because we are having a healthy margin right now. And with the more SaaS model user picks up and a managed services offering picks up, we would be able to increase our margin substantially, because these are not directly related to the people cost. But we are continuing to invest in our R&D and product development, and we expect to do that for next couple of years, because the product is the solution is the key to our success. It's not just a pure time and material kind of a business. It's basically using our solution and a platform which gives a month on month, year on year revenues, and so that we can able to really forecast our growth in the next considerable future.
So no, I okay. A final question from mine, at least. I heard you mention that you've grown on a quarter on quarter basis at 20% for the last 6 quarters. Did I hear you correctly?
Yes, we did about, yeah, I think, yes.
And do you reckon...
More than 20% we have grown in the some quarters.
Okay, but do you reckon that even on a higher base for the next few quarters, a 20% quarter-on-quarter growth is possible? I mean, 20% quarter-on-quarter is unheard of really in the current market scenario.
See, the reason is, if you really look at it, because our volume of revenue was smaller, so we could able to achieve that significant growth.
Now,
so going forward,
base,
it's a different. Sorry,
which is I'm saying. So now at a higher base, do you think that is possible?
So we do currently our pipeline and order currently, which is doable, achievable, and it's a very. But see, it is not. I can't say that I can expand the same growth for the next 3 years or 4 years. But I can able to see in the near future we can able to achieve this kind of revenues. So that is one of the reason actually we are also doing acquisitions and also growing inside the account. In the last 2 quarters, we have added several senior management people on the sales and account mining team. We hired people from General Electric and people from a healthcare business. We hired people from CA Technologies to build our global partnership channels and also European market expansion. So we are adding a different elements to growth fuel. So the growth to us is a very important thing, is we want to maintain a consistent profitability and also to grow on a consistent basis. And the consistent basis we can able to predict only as our SaaS and managed service model matures, which will be a subscriber based revenues. That is a model, and also we are moving into slowly into transaction revenue model also in the near future.
Good chatting with you, Mr. Venkatajari, and thanks so much for taking the time out and speaking with us today.
Thank you.
Well, phenomenal revenue growth, hopes of the margins as well expanding from the current 31.4% levels. No wonder that the stock is continuing to make fresher highs in an otherwise weak, wobbly market.
Unreal, 20% quarter on quarter. That would be substantial YOY growth. But even if it does 20% YOY, that's quite large, even if for a small revenue base. Not too many IT companies are managing to do that. So not bad going, really. 1417 for this one. Okay, but that aside, the market is just about 0.75% down and staying at those levels. Just that the small cap space is a bit more active and doing a bit more than the large caps are. That is where the activity is, because this BSE small cap index, a CNX small cap index, is in the green, which is actually not a bad sign.